So I gave you just, I gave everybody a package. Okay. So I have copies of the full-size plan, but I gave everybody the desktop size that works a little easier than looking at the larger size. And so, since the last meeting, what we did was we eliminated some hay bales and silt fence, added the core logs, retention behind the core log so that we were able to take care of the stormwater comments that came up at the last meeting. And so I can show you all. So before I kind of had the hay bales on the tree line a little further down. And so what I did is I chose basically from here down at elevation 438. So over here, basically running that core log along the elevation there so that it ends up being a 16-inch high. After that, I show it running perpendicular to the contours, and then at an angle to the contour, so that any of the water that comes down the hill over here, at least, would be trapped in on the core log, directed into that retention area behind the core log. So we'll get the retention behind the core log, get some infiltration back into the ground, and then.
Do we think that'll be okay? I mean, it's a pretty steep grade. Do you think the water won't just sheet over?
Or? No, I mean, it should be fine. There's not a lot of water coming off there anyway. Okay. So even for like a 100-year storm, like I said, I think we're at 0.3 CFS coming off the entire site. So for the amount of water that comes off that site, it's not a lot of water.
Total or the increase?
Total.
Oh,
the increase was only 0.14 before. And so now we get rid of the increase by putting this in because we're retaining the water
on the place.
On the site, yeah, exactly.
And this is an 18-inch core or an 18-inch?
16-inch. And so what I did is I gave, I also attached basically the cut sheet that we have from the manufacturer that we call for. And so it's North American green is, who we found makes kind of the better of them that we could find. North American green.
Yes.
So we were looking at, I think, so the 16-inch. They do make a 20-inch, but we don't need a 20-inch volume.
Yep, I was thinking 12. So
16 worked exactly to meet the 100-year storm. Anything, you know, we could go smaller, but we don't meet the 100-year storm pre and post.
Yeah, well, actually, okay.
And so that's why we're moving to 16.
And the plan is for it to just stay?
So the plan is for it to stay. Okay. It's going to grow into a natural berm. And so the sheet kind of shows you it starts the grass in. And so we've actually had some experience with one of their earlier models a couple of years ago in another solar project. So it kind of grows into the terrain, just creates a berm. And I think similar to what I think we talked about the last meeting with the compost too, but this one's a little more beefier.
Lighter.
Well, a little beefier where it's going to stay a lot longer, where it'll hold better than some of the ones that I had looked at, because we had looked at different products and trying to find out which one would be best for the long term.
And you've got that reference somewhere?
I call for it right here. I call for proposed core log North American green, and I call for the specific product number, which is the 16 BPN9. And so, and the
it's
reason
16-inch.
It's so 16 inch, and the reason we call for this one too is the longevity. It's longer life one. Some of the other ones they have are really short life products. So.
What are they wrapped? I'm just wondering, what is it wrapped in? Is that like nylon or something? Or?
Yeah, actually.
I mean, does that eventually go
so
away?
Polynet logs, yeah. So, and then, like I said,
polynet. Okay.
So yeah.
That'll never go away.
Some break them down after. I think it's 18 months. Is whatever. What's
that? Yeah. So actually, yeah. So this one, and like I said, the longevity is the reason we chose this one, because it says longevity greater than 7 years for this product.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So that's why we chose this one, because a lot of them are 1 to 2 years. The ones that in the past actually had a shorter lifespan, but they started because of the technology. Obviously, they started to make better products.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we were looking for it more. I mean, 2 years probably would do it because it would grow in and just be natural by then.
Well, and that's what we were worried about it eroding away, kind of, because that's what we've
seen them do.
Built for less, sometimes you see the material kind of leave. You know what I'm saying? So that's what we're looking for, something a little deep there, so it would stay and kind of grow right into
more
it.
More than we would be looking for, so that's good.
And so by doing that, again, we meet all the stormwater standards now. So what I did is I submitted the checklist. Checklist of stamps.
Sounds good.
You know, we went all through the standards, checked off the standards. I also provided the narrative behind each standard.
Oh.
The back of it. The last three pages is the narrative behind each standard, the staple portion of that. It gets into standard two, which is the peak rate, so you can see how the rates have changed now. Get into the recharge, water quality. I also did attach the TSS removal checklist with a calculation. Just so you can guys see what basically currently exists on site. Because of the amount of grass out there, we get a vegetated filter strip, and then there's that water quality swale basically along the base of the slope. So it runs pretty shallow, so we were able to count that as a water quality swale. It kind of meets the requirements that DEP has for a water quality swale, so that's what we were showing there for our TSS removal requirements. And I did give you the updated calcs also.
Yep.
And I wasn't sure. I know I gave one full set already to the board, and I don't know how many more copies of the full sets you would want for your records. If you don't want any, I can give them to John, and he can give them to the contractors.
We need one for the file and one for anybody else who wants to take one.
So two.
Probably. Well, how about if we take one for the file, we give the rest to Turgis, and he can take them, use them for what he wants.
And that's if you don't need them, just call John, and he can take them, and you can give them to the contractors. It's just less copies to pay for the contractors.
Well, that's what I imagine. The building inspector will bring them over at some point, you know, and he can leave them. Okay.
How many do you usually get at the end of a project?
I think it's either five or seven.
Okay,
so that we have a couple for the file, and I just have a checklist to sign.
So we distribute?
Fire.
So I have five here, maybe you will.
Yeah, that should do it.
There's six.
Yeah, it's okay, I have to keep one.
And I'll give you one off the board.
That's fine, no, I'm good, because I'm done.
Sure.
And now, just for nothing, I don't know if Mark was there, but he did a favorable decision.
He did, okay.
They just want to get through that part of the meeting.
It's a lesson learned. Always plan your meeting right before a contentious one.
A contentious one, right. And then just race them through it. Did you get what were the green cards or whatever that we needed?
Yeah, everything.
You got them, okay.
Yep, there's the green cards, we're all set.
Okay. Did you get a chance to look at the calculations?
Yes.
Okay.
Looks good.
You're good?
It's all set.
I don't think there's anything else. Was there anything else outstanding? I don't remember.
Just want to review. So we received approval with comments, I think, from the fire department, and we also received approval from the police, I believe.
I think this one we had everything.
Did we get comments from anybody else? I think that was it, wasn't it?
Those are the only two departments you guys had talked about it last time, which is probably about right.
And during the ZBA one, just to add to our minutes, the Department of Public Works was talking about they were concerned about a pile of something that they use over there.
It was an old stump pile.
Okay.
A property behind us.
Yeah. And so they were concerned, and the DPW said it's not anywhere near it, nothing to be concerned about.
It's well beyond.
Yeah.
It's about.
Okay.
It's back in here.
Yeah. Okay. And I forget who it was concerned about it, and it turned out to be not an issue. So I think DPW doesn't.
I talked to him afterwards, because I think it should. The gentleman has a point. It is a mess, and it should be chipped up.
Oh, instead of left as a stump pile.
Well, it's adjacent to the transmission lines. I think it's a fire hazard. And on a fire with the scale of the pile, which is probably bigger than this building,
It could burn up to the.
Now?
It's a pretty big pile.
I haven't seen that in a long time.
Yeah. So I would say it's a flame coming from that would reach.
Do they keep feeding it, or are they adding to it?
I checked the other day. There are some new pines on the ground there.
Okay.
And I think they came from the football field or the wherever the pool was.
The old pine grove.
Okay.
That's the old pine grove now.
That's the old one. Okay.
That's where the pines are.
Can they sell it?
They moved it.
Well, you can't ship it out of town with the belt.
So you got to grind it up there.
It has to be either stay in town or ground up.
Or they could do the fire test and then it'd be all gone.
If it's controlled, yeah.
good exercise right there. The new bonfire location is now.
At the end of this weekend, right? I think it's crazy.
Oh, yeah.
That's true. May.
Yep.
They could give themselves their own permit, right? What else was there?
I think that was everything we had. And the comments are in our draft minutes anyway. It talks about police and fire responded. So.
All right.
So as far as waivers requested.
So we have no waivers requested.
Okay, so you completed the checklist, so you're happy.
Correct, so I know originally I had submitted a waiver request.
Right.
And then that's the request of the board, we went and.
You just went and filled them all out and they're all set.
Waiver request, so.
All right, and then I know there was also a question about need for a special permit, because it's, we're in the aquifer district. For this one, I don't know.
I remember you asked that.
Yeah.
Were you gonna check that?
Oh, actually, I think we, oh, we did, I think the building gave you the letter, and we don't need a.
Because I pulled that from a letter that came from the building inspector.
I think you need it.
Yeah, I think.
Building inspector, VHB?
So it's a site plan review approval, special permit and stormwater permit, I think we had all that.
Yeah.
Because I think I just scratched out, in the draft, I just scratched out the question mark and left it in, because we need to have that in there.
Because it is an aquifer district.
Right.
That would cover it.
For this use in an aquifer district, right?
Yeah.
And a lot of use, a lot of.
And this will function as.
It's not a lot of, because you get a permit from the ZBA, right, for that use?
It's an allowed use, but still requires a special permit from the ZBA.
Which you now already received, so.
So did they grant the special permit, or?
They granted the special permit, yes.
Right, but.
Do we have to do one from them?
Or they need more?
And one from us.
Okay.
That's what the building inspector.
That's what the building inspector said.
Then that's what it is.
All right.
That's it.
All right, great, because that's, so that's in the, sort of the draft letter as it is now. If you want, I mean, I can clean this up, get this done.
Well, we're gonna meet in 2 weeks, right?
Less.
Nice.
Yes, so is that timing gonna bother you?
Okay.
So.
That's not a problem.
And you sent a draft to them, right?
We have a post, the post-closure use permit's still being reviewed technically at DEP, and the lease isn't finished until the town annual meeting, because the.
It's on the article, yeah.
That is a warrant article, so we have.
Until then, I mean, at least until then.
Well, to write the, we can close the meeting tonight, and then we issue, vote and issue the approval at the next meeting.
That'll be before town meeting.
Right, so you're outside, okay.
Yes.
Yeah, May 16th is the town meeting, so we're waiting for that anyways.
And I think, when's our meeting?
It's the last on calendar.
Can't be after the 14th.
Yes, DEP will.
When's the election? Wait, when's the election?
That's not till June.
June.
Did you put your papers in, by the way?
Yes, I put my papers in, by the way. May.
May what, 10th, looks like?
First, 11th, Wednesday?
May 11th.
Oh, yeah, we are Wednesday, 11th.
So the 11th.
May 11th.
We're still okay.
May 11th?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
We're not gonna do it.
No, I can do it.
After the post-closure.
May 11th only, we post the meeting, right?
We may.
Can we close them all today?
Then we get a test to post it.
Well, yeah.
But we can close the public hearing.
Yeah, we close the public hearing, and you don't have to go back.
Okay.
And we'll just.
We will send you a draft, did we send you a draft of this already?
I don't think so.
I think we sent it to.
So we'll send you a draft in the meantime, you can look through it, see if we made any mistakes on the plans and the references, make sure we get your names spelled right.
Yeah, the dates and things like that is. We have the right, we have a signature block, okay.
And a signature.
So we signature block.
So we'll sign it.
Sign it tonight?
No, we'll sign it at the next minute. Do you have a set we can sign, and then?
Do you want a paper set to sign, is that what you decide, or?
Or do we do a Mylar?
We usually sign one, and it matters how you can make a copy. Most everyone does, they can just scan our, what we wanna see is that once we sign it, that's the plan that goes out and gets built. If we get a plan back that's not our signed plan, and it's been updated since then.
We can scan that paper out, too.
So that's fine.
It's up to you, preference for you guys, like, what do you guys decide?
Well, if we have these, we'll sign all these, and we can give them out here, but then we want a digital copy, just in case somebody wants to do whatever they wanna do.
That's what we do.
Okay.
Okay.
And then these. Is this you?
No.
No.
Summit, that's the subdivision.
Okay, so we'll hang on to these, sign them next week, or next meeting. Do you want them to come back in and pick them up then, or just leave them at the desk?
He's here, so.
Oh, you're here anyways, okay. Okay.
Take care of it.
Perfect.
Yeah, we're done, we're good.
So we need a motion to close?
Can you do that? I can't do that.
I know, yes.
I can't do that.
All right, a motion, we close the hearing, it's all we, and We'll make a decision at the next meeting.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Have a good weekend.
Appreciate it.
Friday night, huh?
Friday night, this is what we love doing.
Been doing a big Friday.
All right, done. Oh, we're still almost on schedule. We're ahead of schedule. Okay, preliminary subdivision. Are you here for the Malden Brook one?
Nope, I'm here for 99 Harwell Street.
Oh, that's right.
You don't remember.
So what are we gonna do?
I think we just signed a decision tonight, but they did finish up construction this week, so I had an as-built plan to give to the board. I'm not exactly sure what the process is for seeking an occupancy permit, but the client is very eager to.
Right, to keep going there.
Moving forward with the process.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you. Thank you.
That's that one.
Subdivision.
So do you want, should we skip to him to?
You're the chair, you can do whatever you like.
Let's go home.
That's as much power as you've got.
I'll second that one.
Come on up, we'll do your part of the agenda. At 6:20, yeah. I don't think anybody's coming.
So this is for 99 Harwell Street?
Yep.
So where are we at on that? This is not really even an open meeting, it's just an amendment to our.
We are reviewing the.
Stormwater?
Draft stormwater permit under the stormwater bylaw in town, and it's a site plan review, and there's an alteration of greater than 10,000 square feet. We have to review and issue a.
It's done, minor thing.
Stormwater permit. And we drafted one, you guys made comments.
Correct.
And do we have a draft, final draft somewhere, yeah? Next page.
Sign approval page. Sign approval.
There you go.
Well, that's sign approval again, so.
Well, in case there have to be any changes, you can sign the approval, you know, if we make any changes.
Okay.
But the third page is the, just for your signature, so.
That's the wrong job.
The next one.
It's just sign approval and sign approval.
What's the project?
This is what we just talked about.
Okay, so I can throw that away. I'm not gonna do it tonight.
Zooming in on you now.
You all have a copy of it as well.
Yep.
Left a certain way so that, in case you want to.
So we can sign it?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I see, okay.
So we have that, we got comments. Ooh, I have the updated. All right. You gave us a draft where there are still some questions outstanding?
That's the one I had.
Okay, there's a newer one, isn't there, Chris, that has the parking numbers in it?
I didn't see one.
Oh, all right.
That doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
I might have sent it, and it may have been too late. I might have sent it to the wrong place, but. We have those numbers, it was like 72 parking spaces are required, and they have 96 or 74, and they have four handicapped. At least on the last plan I looked at, they had four handicapped shown.
Right on the front page.
Yes.
79 spaces are required, 96 were provided, and that includes four handicaps.
So those are the numbers we insert, yep.
So it was 72 required, you said?
79.
79.
So, okay.
So that was all we needed. I think we went through and we've gotten
He's behind you.
Right. The main thing on this one was that it's drainage, stormwater. You submitted drainage calculations, VHB went back and forth a whole bunch of times.
Charged a whole bunch of money.
We're all happy with it, I assume. I haven't heard anything else. So. So I think we are good. There was one. Oh, my memory's going. There was a condition that I was thinking I wanted to put in as a standard condition in all our approvals. It was a simple one. No, that's already in there, I think. I don't know that it's in this one. But this, because this is a stormwater one. But it was, I don't know that it applied to this one. Have you gotten any contact back from the neighbors on this one?
I did speak with both Steve Migridichian and Waste Management. They were both in agreement after a conversation that, you know, things were constructed appropriately. Steve hadn't kept Waste Management in the loop of what he had approved, and that was really the gist of the upcoming. Waste Management saw construction occurring on their property, and they didn't know what was going on. So it was just a matter of poor communication on the landowner's part.
Because Waste Management leases from them.
And you were just rearranging that drain up into their...
Correct. The drainage system that we installed out at the front had an overflow into their basin.
Into their basin, okay. And that's what they were talking about? All right, you want to make a... Or somebody want to make a motion to... Or do you have any more questions or points?
No.
Anything else? Any more discussion?
Nope.
Want to make a motion to say to approve this?
You got it. Motion to, if anyone else wants to, you're welcome to jump in. Motion to approve the application for a stormwater management permit. And we can sign the draft.
99 Hartwell?
For 99 Hartwell Street. Good, thank you.
Is that on there?
Yeah.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, let's sign.
All right.
So what do you want in there? Is it 96 and 4 or 79 and 4? 96?
79 and 4, because 96 is the first word in the paragraph there, in the number.
96, okay, so 79.
Using your free pen?
Yes.
It is.
He's already in here with the as-built. That's what he's going to say next anyway, so we're good. We hold on to this and see where we go. You want to handle the as-built?
Well, what would we do? Do we want to do any inspection?
Yes, he's going to submit it. We're not going to.
Oh, yeah, we can take it then.
Yeah, that's my question. The as-built was actually finished up today. The surveyors were out there yesterday doing the survey work. Paving was completed on Wednesday.
Really? Okay.
So the owner is eager to keep things moving forward. So we have an as-built plan for you. I don't know what the formal process that you have.
It's in your approval.
It is.
But it says we need a engineer's certificate.
Okay.
And engineer certification of how it was built. The as-built should say if there's anything that was different from the design that was approved.
Okay.
And then...
And VHBs.
And we will send it to VHB for them to check and make sure they have the same information as what you have.
Okay.
And then once that's...
We've got to put how we voted on the page 2.
Oh.
That's on the back.
Oh,
there it is.
On the back.
It's got a clean copy.
Oh, wait, where's that thing about the...
Let's see, sir.
The parking spaces. That's on page 1? Okay.
But C will be checked. Oh, okay. That's a clean copy.
So I think that should be it.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I will leave 5 copies of the as-built with you. I assume you can get that over to VHB.
Can you email an electronic version?
I certainly can.
Save paper that way?
Yep.
Along with your
letter of certification letter? Right. Okay.
We'll get that all to VHB. And what's your schedule? Like next meeting, you want to come back in?
Ideally, yeah. If everything were ready next meeting. I like I said, I don't know what your process is.
It's possible.
Does the planning board make a recommendation to the building department for issuance? Or
no, he doesn't issue the permit until we issue a certificate of completion.
Okay.
Our certificate of completion is when our engineer says that you built it according to what you said you were going to build.
Okay.
So he says it's okay, then we talk about it.
Let him go.
Almost always agree with him. And then we sign a certificate of completion.
Okay, so if all's in order by next meeting, I should expect you would sign your certificate.
The only thing is if VHB can put it in their schedule.
Right.
Okay, great. Well, thank you for your time.
Okay.
Thank you.
Enjoy your weekend.
And what's the time frame for getting the occupant? Whoever it is, FedEx or...
I know he was shooting for May 1st, so he's a little bit behind schedule, but...
Well, he's done other things at risk. He can just say okay for them, you know.
Yeah, well, it's a matter of the building inspector.
The building inspector.
Allowing them
key
into the building, yeah.
Right.
So that's
general, he's done things at risk.
He's done some temporaries, which you may want to ask for like a 30-day temporary, and then that would work out.
Okay. Would he be seeking a recommendation from the planning board for that? Or?
We hope so.
Yeah, okay. And we would say sure. I mean, it's a...
For a 30-day, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Appreciate that. Thank you very much.
No problem. That's
fine. You got all that one, Raj?
Oh, where are we going to do that one?
You're in charge. Where do you want to go?
What do you mean? Steinbeck, I'm asking. Because, is he our new clerk?
No, no, this is how it was going on.
All right, it's done. All right, the Malderbrook Realty one. The preliminary plan, I asked, I called the chief, and he says he's not going to do anything until we have the real plan. He says he likes it, but he wasn't going to get his...
No comments? That's fine.
No comments until the real plan.
They have a certain amount of time, and if there's...
Sergeant, not the chief?
Well, I ended up talking to the chief, and he said, well, if you want to get anything, I can have him do it, or we can just wait until it's not a preliminary, it's a real plan, and then I'll have the sergeant do it. I said, okay, we'll do that so we can finish this up, so...
Sounds good. So we need to write a decision. That was, I knew there was one more thing that we needed to do. We, under our subdivision regs, we can approve...
I don't know.
Deny, or what?
We should approve.
We can approve with conditions or deny it.
But preliminary?
Even for a preliminary?
I'm pretty sure that's, do we have the subdivision regs? Anyone have a copy of it?
I don't know if I brought them.
I know I get the zoning, but...
I think I only have zoning, unfortunately.
Yeah, I just have zoning.
Yeah, me too.
I have the website if you want to look them.
Check minus.
Yeah, pull up the website. Wow, it's handy to have.
I know.
Planning board, and they have...
It's actually not planning board, I think it's like...
Subdivision regs.
It's under...
It's within the planning board section.
Yeah, e-government, right.
Oh, that's a, yeah, I don't want one of those.
They're free.
No, just use them here.
Great.
Well, that's an actual, that's a good idea.
You can look up that way.
Did he request any waivers, you recall?
Yes.
His preliminary plan may be submitted to the planning board, and any waivers concerning the required content may be requested at this time. The planning board shall act on any waiver request submitted with the preliminary plan within 30 days.
Yep.
You're saying this is a zoning by, which one?
No.
That's zoning, what I just read.
No. No, that's site plan review.
Yes.
That doesn't apply. We're doing subdivision, preliminary subdivision.
Oh, you want to see the regs to see what, okay.
Subdivision regulations.
That was under e-government.
What am I smoking?
Good, because I was worried, I'm like, that didn't sound quite right, but that's okay.
This, yeah, what am I thinking? This is subdivision.
Well, now I'm on the front page. Now go to our page.
Let's see if this is something else, and then...
Until we get to our page. It's not on there. Oh, additional links. Site plan review.
Subdivision regulations. And then there's a preliminary subdivision section. And then it'll say decisions.
So it's not under subdivision control?
No.
As general bylaws.
Is this the new website?
No, it's the mobile version.
Oh.
It's a little bit different than I'm expecting.
Subdivision rules and regs.
Okay.
It's not in there.
There you go.
There it is.
You know where it is in there?
Yep, it's preliminary on two pages or so. Definitions. Keep going. Those are still definitions. Oh. A&R, keep going.
I don't know what to worry about. This is what I said in the minutes.
Preliminary plans. Okay.
Keep going. What's this?
Form and content?
Yeah, keep going.
Notice of action?
Approval, that's it.
Right.
The waivers on the plan.
As soon as practical, after the date of its submission, the planning board shall study the preliminary plan and discuss it with the applicant. Failure to complete the application requirements or provide the planning board with any information it requests shall be grounds for disapproval. Within 45 days of submittal of the preliminary plan, the planning board shall approve the preliminary plan with or without modification or conditions suggested by the planning board or Board of Health Board of Health.
Yeah, the Board of Health has to comment. They have, a lot of times when it's a septic system, but it's on sewers, but, so I'm not sure we even heard back from the Board of Health.
Or agreed upon by the applicant, or shall disapprove the preliminary plan, giving the reason or reasons for such disapproval. Such what?
Nothing, I was just looking for something like that.
Such decision shall be sent to the applicant by certified mail. The time within which the planning board must act on a preliminary plan may be extended by the planning board upon written request. Approval of preliminary plan does not constitute approval of proposed subdivision at the preliminary plan. It doesn't really say what we're supposed to do.
Well, it says we have 90 days, wasn't it?
45.
Oh, that's right, this is residential. So then we have 45 days to act, but we have to make a decision. We can either approve it with conditions, or deny it. But it seems, I think we had, we looked at it, there were really no issues. They were gonna verify some of the wetlands. Looking at our minutes, the comments that we got back from VHB were not substantial.
Right.
Was there one about their...
The idea of a walking path through the subdivision to have connectivity?
Yep.
Whether it was in a wetlands...
Requesting waivers for certain application standards.
Oh, that's a minute. I'm thinking of the VHB letter, and their first concern was whether it was in a...
Watershed area? It is in the watershed, but there are no limitations on it. So I, yes, I would motion to approve the plan, and actually, I guess, did you read anything about waivers? We don't issue waivers at the preliminary stage, we just give them feedback on it. No, that was...
Yeah, I don't recall.
We just give feedback on...
The planning board shall approve the preliminary, with or without modifications or conditions suggested by the planning board or Board of Health or the agreement by the applicant. Or shall disapprove.
Right.
So we can. Oh, not waivers, though.
Right, so what we wanna do is, I can draft a letter, unless anyone else wants to.
I don't wanna.
I'll jump. So we can draft a letter, but we can motion, we can act on it tonight to approve it, to be within the 45 days. Because when was the April 13th, and we got it? When was it submitted?
Can you bring that in on the day? It says March 9th, though. They didn't have delivery.
Yep. Okay. If you can scan that, can you scan that and send that to me? Yeah, we should just...
Maybe it's approved by now.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter either way. They want to get some feedback to do the definitive, so that's really what we want to do. They're not trying to hold any zoning because the zoning's not changing. That's when the timeframes really get tight. Because if we were going to change the zoning in this area, he could submit a preliminary plan.
So that he's locked in the zone.
Hold in the old zoning, but there are no zoning changes on this. So the time frame is just, as long as we're reasonable, and we're less than 60 days anyway, so.
Is that one of our meetings, March 9th? I should have my calendar.
Yeah, sounds right.
That's probably why it was hand-delivered, because I think it's stamped by council, because we brought to the meeting. And that's probably exactly what it is. But it does say on March 9th.
Yeah, because it... In this one, it says the minutes of March 23rd meeting, so 2 weeks before that would be the 9th. Yep. So he submitted it. If you can scan that and send it over to me with a reminder to draft the preliminary approval.
Reminder.
There's still a motion hanging out there.
To approve.
Motion to approve.
Right? Approve the preliminary.
With conditions.
With conditions.
What conditions?
That'll be mentioned, that'll be included in this. For the connectivity to allow like walking through the whole area to verify the wetlands.
Okay.
And it was, I think there might have been something on the sewer, but I don't remember that. Yeah, the low pressure sewer.
Sure. Whether it's multi lines or single line?
Yeah, right.
And then what about the negotiations with the person who's whatever is in the right of way?
There is no negotiation. The person is encroaching on the town's right of way.
Right, but they got to talk to the person.
Why? Well, they should.
Just destroy it?
They can.
Drive over it with a dump truck?
They can, but that'll come up on the Definitive.
Definitive, very good. Actually, that'll come up when the definitive, or when that starts and the butter gets a letter.
Yes.
All right, so we'll invite them in.
Oh, they will be here, I'm sure.
Yeah. Awesome.
And then the curved line versus straight line for the lot width.
Oh, yeah, so you can, with the cord length or whatever.
Yep.
Do you want to second that?
Second.
Any more discussion on, are you clear on what you want to, oh, you're not writing the letter. You clear on the letter?
I think so.
Good. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
In favor? No, he doesn't like it at all.
I know connectivity was in here somewhere.
I don't think it made it to any, oh, it was in the minutes?
Yeah.
I know we talked about it, I don't know. Maybe we should have our meetings on Friday nights more often. I'm even tireder than Wednesday night. Tony? Oh, sure.
There it is.
Signed by law. Looks good. All right, let's go.
Signed by law. There was a draft that was sent to the
Yeah, it's in the
selectmen. It's on the warrant. Do we have any, do we need to make any changes to that on the floor? I don't think so, but I hope not, but.
Should we should make a, you think we're going to want to add the time back in and just make a printed amendment sheet that has that all in it?
I think that's in the warrant. Basically this.
Yeah.
Oh, right, but if we're going to want to amend it, you know, we'd have to write up the amendment?
I think.
Pre-write an amendment?
I think that would be, so you mean if we want to go in proposing a different language?
Well, what I'm saying is, if this sounds like it's not going to go because people in the audience are saying, no, I don't like something, the time being zero.
Yeah.
How about if we amend it to be the time being whatever, something else? Here's our amendment. Now let's
have the wording ready.
Have the wording ready. Right.
So we go in the way it is.
Yeah.
If we
yeah.
hear a lot of
we have
pushback.
We're prepared to say, all right, we'll change it to be.
And right, we want to have the wording.
And the only reason I want to do this is because there's other things in here I don't think people will care about, but I don't want to lose that change because somebody doesn't like the timing.
Right, which is what we started this whole thing. That makes sense.
So rather than
an amendment ready, the wording ready?
And the amendment will be.
So instead of no more than once per minute, we could sort of change it to no more than once per 10 seconds or 15 seconds.
No less than 10 seconds or whatever.
Whatever.
How the word.
We could just pre-write the thing with the line for the 10 or 15 or 20 seconds or whatever the people.
Yep. So we want to have that.
They lined out.
Yeah.
No more than once per minute.
Right, because that's the proposed amendment.
Well, we
proposed to delete that. Yeah.
Right. And so we propose that for the
Based
town
upon
meeting. But if we get into town meeting and we hear that 90% of the people don't like the idea of no time limit, which is one of the things we were worried about. We want to be ready to be able to amend on the floor to make it 5 seconds or 10 seconds so that there is a bit of time so people can actually read something instead of it just zipping through.
But the way, now maybe I'm reading this wrong, but the way that they have it on the warrant, it just says that the full digital image or portion therefore may change, but no portion of the image may scroll. So there's really, it says it could change.
Right.
They're not putting any.
No time limit.
No right. time.
Correct.
There's no time limit.
Yep.
So correct. I mean, it could be a minute, it could be 30 seconds, it could be 15 seconds.
Yep.
Yep.
I mean, so is that what you want?
Well, that's what we're worried about.
Right. That's what we would rather have it 5 or 10 seconds
some
is what
amount
I keep hearing. Some
yeah.
short amount of time so that there's.
So you know that there's no instantaneous
you
change.
You think that the townspeople might not agree with this?
Right. They may think the way we think, the idea of
no, earlier, earlier during the planning board meetings, while we are discussing, we were thinking of putting 15 seconds delay.
Right.
But it went to the select board.
The select board specifically asked for no.
No limit.
Yeah.
So that's why it came back to us again.
But okay, because the way, like I said, the way I'm reading it, it just says it may change.
Yep.
So there's really no
no time
change.
None, right.
They could leave it up for an hour,
zero,
they could leave it up for half a second.
Five, it's not 10, it's not a minute.
It's
it just could change, and then change whatever.
Whatever.
Yeah, it's the time component that's just been
so
removed.
So basically what the board is thinking is that when we go to town meeting, is that someone may want to put a specific time in there.
Yep.
Or a minimum time. I think we would want to move.
Right, so a minimum. And we want to be able to have that wording ready so that we're not struggling in the middle of town meeting, because there are some other more like serious comments on here to make changes to, so it...
That I don't think anybody will take issue with.
Right.
You know, but we don't want to, then to vote it down based on this time problem and lose the other...
So basically, what's in the warrant, what are you looking for?
Yeah, if they want that, we'll do it.
Yes, but if we...
Like, when they get down to 5.6 E2 business centers, there's a lot of stuff that's, you know, that's crossed off, and I just wanted to make sure that...
Right, because it got, with that, it was confusing.
Yeah.
It was confusing, and actually, the building inspector was looking at that and comparing it to the other section where the table was, and he was interpreting it differently than the way we intended, so we reworded it so it's more clear.
And to him, it seemed contradictory, so that's kind of what we were trying to straighten out.
One question I have is, when we get to town meeting, at the beginning, but sort of before the presentation, we're asked sort of whether we recommend approval or not.
Yeah, that's...
Presumably, initially there, does the board agree with recommending approval to this, and then we'll see where the discussion goes?
Yeah, because I mean, I don't think there's anything wrong with doing it this way.
Yeah.
I just think that if people have concerns, we can accommodate their concerns. You know, I think... I mean, does anybody else have any...
I mean, based upon the feedback that we have received publicly, either from the Board of Selectmen or at the public hearing, we didn't get, at least I didn't hear, a lot of negative feedback about we need to have 10, 15, or some amount of time.
Now, I'm just thinking that we didn't have a big turnout. If somebody comes to the town meeting and then they... Because that was an issue at some point, you know, people were talking about it.
Yeah.
You know, and I just don't want... to go to town meeting and then those people show up at town meeting even though they didn't come here.
Yeah.
And they say, no, we liked it before with a minute, you know, what should we do or something, you know, and we can sort of have some conversation on the town meeting floor as to the wording of the amendment and try to get them to 10 seconds or something.
So what are we wording? No less than 1 minute?
If we were going to do an amendment like
some
that,
minutes.
I would suggest, so basically we put back the way most of the language was previously, where it says no more than once per minute, and just change it to no more than once per 10 seconds or something like that.
What about what about
put in 10 seconds, then they can cross it out and make it something.
Well, it's going to be an amendment on
the
floor.
It's going to be a verbal.
So, no, we're going to have to have, they want it written down.
That's why I want to have this there.
Well, we can just leave a space there, and then when we're at the town meeting, if everybody is kind of saying, well, we'd be happy with it at 15 seconds, write in 15 seconds and hand that to them. Or if they say, if we can suggest 10 seconds, and if everybody seems like, oh, that's a good idea, that's a reasonable amount of time to read something, we write it in and send it in. So you just leave a blank.
Is it as majority of the people has to say, or?
I think it's two-thirds.
Two-thirds majority, yep.
Oh, yeah, and it's a zone. Might as well, we'll ask for unanimous, so we don't have to count.
Yes.
You know, just so you know, that when in the other town that I lived in, okay, at the end of each article on the warrant, they used to put down like what the selectmen voted, what the planning board voted, and what the finance committee voted. You know, depending on what the article was,
so you knew what
so
the
that people
recommendations
would read it, they would know. Okay, one article, this article, this is Article 26. Okay, board of selectmen voted. You know. 500, planning board voted, you know, 500, you know, there's no money involved, so there would be no need for, you know, for the FinCon to be on there. Maybe that's something that they may want to look into doing. So
I mean, we could have
so people know in advance how the board of selectmen or the planning board of FinCon, you know, voted on the article before, you know, because they're sitting there reading, looking through this, you know, so they know beforehand at the meet, before they go to the meeting.
It would be nice. I think it's a timing thing, just because to get that into this, you tend to have to have a preliminary warrant that you send out to all these places.
Right.
You know.
Well, I guess that's more of a bookkeeping thing that the town clerk would do.
Right.
Contemporaneously, right?
And right, well, if she can do that, but like if there's, I don't know.
Well, like this year we were very late.
Warrants that are coming out late, people don't know what to say until that gets sent to them.
Yeah.
You know. And I don't know if they'd all have enough time to say.
And you're adding one new section to this bylaw.
Yes.
Right? That 50.
For the business centers?
5-6, no, the residential districts.
Yeah. You want to talk about what was supposed to be middle high school?
Is the high school in a residential district? Okay.
I'm pretty, yes.
Well, yeah, so we acknowledge the fact that the high school has a digital display sign currently.
Right.
We also.
Flashes and change colors and they have snowflakes.
Right, and we, so it's there. We talked about the fact of adding something so that you cannot have digital display signs in residential districts. I don't recall hearing.
Any talk.
Hearing that people were in favor of, you know, if we were gonna include this new residential district limitation, that we were essentially trying to get the high school to remove the current.
I'm just curious because, you know, you're talking about residential districts and then you said except at the West Boylston Middle High School.
Yeah.
I was just curious, is the high school, is it, you know, considered a residential area?
Yes, it's in a residential district.
Well, then that makes sense, you know.
Yep.
The only thing that comes up there is that we're giving them an exception. I hope they don't interpret that as they can do whatever they want with the sign.
No, this is.
They're still gonna comply.
Yeah, I know, but they.
The standard of the.
Right. I don't know if they're gonna interpret.
They're gonna have to follow the 50.
Oh, all the rest of the rules.
E1 duration, they would have to follow all of that.
It's supposed to.
Which basically says, but no portion of the image may scroll, twirl, change color, imitate movement in any manner or meet the characteristics of a flashing sign. Am I correct?
Yep.
Yes, absolutely.
That's right.
Now they're doing it.
Right.
So once this gets approved, they're not gonna be able, but I bet there'll be some residuals to that, I'm sure.
Well, I mean, the thing about the sign is it wasn't okay before, it's still not okay.
Right now, it's not in compliance, so.
The two sections or whatever, and it'll become in compliance with the residential part. All right, so let's, what do you think about the recommend approval or not? I would say we should just.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
That'll encourage people to like it.
How long till town meeting? We have a meeting before town meeting?
We do.
Yeah, 11.
So at that, we need the, at that meeting, we will decide on the town warrant. And we look through all the town warrant articles and then we make a recommendation.
Shoot, we did get those.
We would vote on that at that meeting, at our next meeting, so we'll have that as an item on this.
That's good.
I know, I haven't had time to review it though.
That's good.
We're gonna review the budget line, funding ones?
No.
Hey, you wanna come to our?
No.
I didn't think so.
You want a copy of the warrant that she emailed, is that what you're saying you want?
Yeah, just forward that along to people, yeah. And we wanna review the warrant on our meeting.
I mean, everybody should all have it.
So we're all set. We need an item on our agenda to review the warrant and make recommendations as needed.
Warrant is on the website.
Cool.
Right, it's available in a bunch of different places, but we need to have it on our agenda to make recommendations.
Yep.
All right.
Perfect.
Done. Oh, so do you wanna make a motion whether we vote to recommend approval?
No, do that next time.
Next time, we'll review the whole.
Well, I was gonna say about that one. They don't do it all at once.
All at once. Doesn't, I mean.
We'll recommend approval of the entire warrant.
Let's see what happens.
New business, do you wanna put this, just say this is under new business?
Yes.
What?
Yes.
The DOT meeting?
All right, so as the board may, recall, last year.
I think I have to recuse myself.
Last year, this board signed a letter.
DCR property and.
It's DOT thing.
It's a DOT project, but it's proposed and the work is under.
You can sit out there or you can stay there, I don't care.
Yeah, I know, I just got a phone call, so I might as well return it.
Fair enough.
All right.
You're in good hands.
So the board may recall this letter last year that was.
Which is a copy here?
That was approved and signed by the planning board. Melanie, do you know if we have the actual signed version of this letter from June 30th, 2015?
Yeah, I'm sure you have it in there.
If we could attach. If we could.
Really?
If we could attach a copy or.
I can sign this one.
Or a PDF or something of that actual signed letter that was sent to DOT. And.
Who's gonna go to, it's gonna go.
To.
This guy.
Go with this second letter?
Yeah.
Yeah, with the sec, we wanna attach it with the letter dated today. To include it, because it's referred to in the letter dated today.
Can we just sign this one just in case you can't find it and you can say that this is the one?
You can, but I'm good. To be on the safe side, go ahead, but since it's your signature anyway, I think I can have a sign or something, but.
What?
I'm sure you can find it.
I know.
The whole project is the 140 going down the hill by the dump or the.
Stormwater improvements?
Oh, going into 140, or going into.
Headed towards Boylston.
Into Boylston, right down by the reservoir, and there.
So the issue is, I guess, so there's a meeting on Monday that the Mass DOT is holding here.
Yeah.
Right, to talk about the project. And right now, they're proposing stormwater improvements, but they're not proposing, you know, widening the roads or providing, you know, a safer road where the grade is the curve, the S curve with the grade, and that's sort of where 140 coming in from Boylston, you know, narrows significantly.
An 18-wheeler almost pushed me off the road.
I know that there's been issues there.
He was coming down.
On a number of occasions.
Did you see my hand?
No.
He come flying around that bend.
Yeah.
That was nasty, boy.
In the winter?
It was at night.
I can imagine. I can imagine. Because, I mean, you're on that straight shot of Boylston.
You can't see a lot of the shoulder, and some of the shoulder.
There isn't any.
Has a ravine in it, you know? And so, like, if you go over too far, you're gonna get in that. But I said, that guy come flying down, and I don't know if he was just coasting or what, but he came flying down that hill.
Yeah.
And he made that curve, and it was like, it was scary.
Yeah, and I mean, given the, you know, given the effort to, you know, work towards this whole complete streets program that the Board of Selectmen is gonna be talking about, I believe it's next week, at their meeting next week, this seems to fit in nicely with all of that.
I know that he's.
I'm not here.
Okay. Would they be able to widen the road without affecting DCR property and, you know, the reservoir?
I mean, the right of way, I should think, should be able to compensate what it is, you know.
Or is that a question for them on Monday?
That'd be a great question for them. Speaking of which, can anybody on the board make the meeting on Monday? I think it's at 6:30.
Right.
That would be wonderful.
Yep.
If one or two of us could.
Because that would be the only, you know, I mean, I understand and I agree with you about widening the road.
Yeah.
But if you look at both sides of the road, the water, as you come down that hill, on your left-hand side, that inlet.
Yeah.
Is really close. And I don't know how far they could go out without affecting, you know, the reservoir and all of that, and how they would protect that particular area, you know, as far as any of the salt.
Well, I'm thinking there's maybe more space on the other side, away from the reservoir, that they could expand a little bit.
But I don't even know how they would be able to cut out that curve. That would be a really tricky thing. Unless they come out, as they come down, they go out wider and come in this way. That's the only way. But like you said, I think if you're coming down the hill, it would have to be on the right-hand side. I don't think that you'd be able to do it on the left side because, like you said, that inlet is like really close to the road and, you know, you don't want to really mess that up.
But even if, I mean, they're going to be digging up the road, doing work there now, even if, okay, maybe we can't make it perfectly straight, but any improvements that could be done there, I think, would be well worth the effort.
No, I agree with you. Like I said, you know, as far as widening the road, you know, that's you know, that would be the issue.
Absolutely, absolutely. So
this is basically a DOT project.
DOT project. Yep. Okay. They're going to be here on Monday to talk about.
It's all funded by them.
I believe. I don't know if.
Or DCR?
I think it's federal and state funds, if memory serves.
So it's not coming out of anything from the towns, from either West Boylston or Boylston?
Not to my knowledge. I believe it's all state and federal. This is all posted, this public hearing, it's posted sort of on the state website. I didn't see it on the town website, but it's posted
on the state. Well, I saw that there was a meeting, you know, on Monday.
Oh, okay.
For this year.
Oh, I missed that.
But that's all I saw.
Okay, but so that's the motivation for the letter. It's an opportunity to sort of you know, again, send this message to Mass DOT and also, you know, to the Board of Selectmen, that now is sort of our opportunity to
to make this issue known.
Did anybody get my email?
I didn't get anything from you, no.
Would it be?
Did you? The one I sent to John?
Would it be advantageous to send a copy to Senator Chandler and Representative O'Day?
Couldn't hurt.
Wow, now you're talking.
Now we're really trying to get this to go up the food chain.
It's what we put him in office for, is to help us when we need help. I mean, even though it's a DOT project, it's still a hazard. You know, it's a dangerous curve. You know, God forbid, you know, anybody got killed on that road. Poor deer, you know, they come across and they get smashed, but you know.
Yeah.
I mean, since you're sending the letter out to them, I don't know if it's even worthwhile. I would just say, yeah, CC both of them and let them know the issue, because they've come before the Board of Selectmen and say, you know, do you have any issues? Do you have any, anything going on? So, you know, I don't see why you guys can't do it if you have an issue with, you know, stuff like this.
I guess my only, I think it's a great idea. My only concern with it is that I wouldn't want that to come across from the Board of Selectmen's position of, are they trying to go over our head kind of a thing on an issue like this?
Why not?
Okay, but as a board, right, it's specifically something for them, you know, that the planning board is doing. I would think that you would have every, you know, right to do what you feel is necessary, you know?
Yep.
And if you feel it's necessary as a board to, you know, CC the state senator and our state rep, I don't see as that as being going over somebody's head, because you're an elected body just as much as they are.
Yeah.
You know?
No, I hear you. I
mean, if it was like the ZBA, which is appointed by the Board of Selectmen, then yeah, there may be, you know, a little, you know, the chair would probably have to, you know, send something to the chair of the Board of Selectmen and say, hey, this is what we'd like to do, you know, just like the town council.
Yeah.
If we have anything, we have to go through them to get to town council, you know.
No,
so I don't see it as an issue.
I hear you.
We can even ask them if they mind if we do it. I mean, I would love to do it just to get, this is like my spot that I want to get fixed all through town.
Yeah.
So I sent John a meeting and I called the police about how many accidents there have been there, just to say whether it's a safety or not a safety.
Yeah.
So I said, tonight, the planning board is going to discuss the DOT work on 140. They are proposing some drainage work, pavement, and line painting, but we are going to ask them for more. We want them to widen the road and realign it for safer cars, pedestrians, and bicycles. Our strategy is to tell them that we will only support the project if they apply their own Mass DOT Healthy Transportation Policy Directive, which requires the changes to accommodate pedestrian and bicycle traffic, as I understand it. The area is currently not safe for cars, let alone pedestrians and bicycles. This is according to the West Boylston Police. I didn't call the state police to find out if they've got their own reports. There have been 37 accidents reported by the WB police since 94. My opinion is that the addition of drainage grates in the bicycle area, being the edge of the road, may make the road less safe for bicycles if the rider rides out into travel lanes to go around the grate. You'd mention that as a, who knows? Well, somebody did. Maybe it was just somebody else.
No, I mentioned, you said something about the grates, but I'm pretty sure they don't use the same type of grates where the tire can get stuck, but bike riders like to go around grates sometimes, so.
I mean,
even still.
They should use the right grate and it should be fine. They're not going to get stuck like they used to.
Yeah.
Have an accident, but that doesn't mean though.
I just think sometimes if they see anything that could be uneven, they try to go around.
They just avoid it.
And that could be dangerous, more dangerous,
Especially that. So I was going to just let them know that we were going to sort of counter them and say we don't just wholeheartedly approve whatever you want to do. We were going to say we don't approve it unless you apply your own Mass Health or Mass DOT Healthy Transport Policy. And I was reading through that. There's a bunch of different things we could apply for. The safety one, the fact that it clearly says all projects should enhance pedestrian and bicycle transportation. You know, I mean, there's a few places that they haven't really done that at all, you know, in this project. Yeah. And I'll go to, maybe they have, and they just haven't presented it as such, I don't know. So we'll listen to their spiel and then ask them for more.
Is this where complete streets can come into handy?
It's mentioned in there. Yeah, it's mentioned in that policy. Oh, so what I said to John is I feel that the risk of not supporting the project is minimal. If the project is built as I believe it is proposed, the town stands to gain new pavement and line painting. The drainage work is not a benefit to the town since I believe it will make the bicycle travel less safe, or it's minimally, that we don't have a flooding problem down there, so it's not a, the only benefit is to the drinking water in the reservoir because they're gonna filter it instead of just letting it run in, you know? If we can get them to change the project to include straightening and widening the road to include safe bike or pedestrian lanes, that would be a tremendous gain to the town. So I think that the win-loss there is worth arguing for, you know? And I don't think that Chandler and O'Day, you know, I don't think that they would, I guess the only thing that I would say about that is I would hesitate sending them a letter that says we won't approve the project, you know? Here's the project the DOT is presenting. Mm-hmm. We don't want to approve it because, or we don't want to support it because it doesn't have the things we want. If we can phrase it a little bit differently so that we're saying, hey, thank you for this DOT project or whatever in your district and we're happy with all this, we want to upgrade it or something like that. I mean, I don't want to send them a letter saying we don't like what they've done.
Yeah.
You know, so far. I mean, that's the only thing that I would say about including them in the letter. But I want to go to it now. And,
yeah.
I mean, get that. I want to get that straightened out or something like that down there. Perfectly straight.
Perfectly straight. Exactly.
And I don't think you're the only one here.
Well, I think there's a lot of people who would. I just don't think anybody knows about this meeting or that they're planning to do anything, you know?
I would suspect that people that ride bikes would be all in favor of why
not getting potentially killed every time they go down there.
Because it is kind of, especially now that the weather's getting, you know, better.
We could even put a bike rack down.
Bike rack?
You know, a bike rack.
It looks like that. There is no response.
Oh. What else was I going to say about the... Oh. No. Oh, that was going to be a plank for when I'm running, you know, to try to get elected. I was going to stand up and say, I'm also running for election soon, so if you want to have this...
Stand down there
with signs in the DOT. Oh, right there. I'll put my name right on which are guardrails.
What do they call it? Attractive nuisance, I think, right? That would be wonderful. I would definitely support us sending such a letter.
Yeah, is the language harsh? More harsh than we should send to the Board of Police to support this project? If the work meets the common sense standard, okay.
Yeah, so this is, that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. Benign. This may be what you're...
The planning board is herein asking the Board of Selectmen to not approve this work for the town's roadway.
But I mean, at the same time, there comes a point when you have to sort of state what your position is and be clear, you know? So is the middle ground keeping the language, but just being a little careful about who we send it to?
Or do we just go hold on? I mean, we could just do it, you know, and see what happens. The thing that I think people won't like seeing is the planning board is asking the Board of Selectmen not to approve this project. I don't think that O'Day and Chandler are going to see that and be like, so what does he want us to do? You know, I mean, I don't know. That's what I'm cautious of.
Yeah, no, I hear you.
Do you want to do it as currently designed? Not approve the project that's currently designed?
Yeah. You can do that.
That way it's a little more wiggle. I'm not
or
sure.
Or not approve the current. Yeah, the current.
Just some way to kind of smooth it a little. Still say no is what it sounds like you want.
Actually, have we seen the current project in any depth?
I have not.
Yeah. Have you?
There were some descriptions of what they were going to do on the state website where they had the public hearing. I didn't see any plans or anything.
So maybe we'll... Do you think there's any point in getting this approved tonight to send out before that meeting on Monday?
I would think so.
If you're going to do it, you would.
Yeah, Monday is... That's where they're asking for feedback.
Well, we can approve the letter. We can approve the letter with...
Hopefully you can approve the letter and then just wait for them to do their presentation. If their presentation says, and we're widening this area by 5 feet on each side, then you fold it up and you put it in the
file. You throw away into a tablet.
But if you want to be ready, then like you said, at town meeting, the idea of having a wording, just have it ready, and then if you don't need it, you
can. Let's give it a shot. We'll see if we get in trouble.
I'll support you, Mark.
Okay.
Are you going to
ZBA?
Down?
Huh?
You're going to go to that one?
Oh, yeah.
Good day.
Because I travel that road every day to go to work and come home from work.
Oh, that's true.
You
know,
and like before you came in, I almost got swiped off the road. And late at night by an 18-wheeler that was coasting down the road.
Should I add the anecdotal? And my daughter's turning 16, and I've been driving with her, and this is where we're learning to negotiate whatever. Because we live in the West Boylston, and their dance studio is in Boylston, so we do that twice. When we're going to dance, it's white knuckle. Well, even though I'm in the passenger seat.
Chris, you said that you didn't see any plans on the state website.
I didn't see. It doesn't mean they're.
No, I
could have missed them, but I didn't see any.
Hopefully, Monday when they come, they'll have something.
Board of Selectmen going to that meeting?
So.
Huh?
Board of Selectmen going to that meeting?
I have no idea who's going to the meeting. You and I will be there.
I think I mentioned 6:30 before. Take that with a grain of salt. I'm not 100% sure that's what it said, but just might be 6, or might be. I don't think it was 7.
It's on the Mass.
They told us.
Yeah. That's where I found it.
On the West Boylston.
Whenever it was.
Well, I'm not going on the calendar.
I have it at 6:30 also.
Yeah, it might be on the calendar. I didn't check the calendar. Oh, okay.
Well, no. When we went for Complete Streets, Board of Selectmen announced it.
Yes.
And it was at 6:30. She said it was at 6:30.
Sounds good then.
Well, that's why I wrote it in there, right? Because
And for that Complete Streets, there's quite a bit of money to get stuff done.
So we each got our own tablet?
Huh?
No.
Yeah, you can do that.
All right, so let's try it.
You got a signable copy.
Yeah, so let's just leave it as is, because that's easier.
So, is this getting mailed? Are these people going to be here? Is that what you're doing?
They're going to be here.
They're going to get it Monday. They're not going to get it now. This goes out even in the mail tomorrow.
FedEx?
They're going to have it Monday.
Next day?
Can we fax it?
If you'd like to.
Oh, we can email it for them.
Do we have everybody's email? Can we do email, like, on Monday or something?
I mean, I'll certainly bring it on Monday, but it would be nice for them to get
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. And that way, at least the town administrator, Board of Selectmen gets it.
I mean, these guys will get it, yeah.
Yeah.
Board of Selectmen, DPW, I'll find out all the names of the transportation committee, that's not a problem.
And that way.
Well, John actually kind of already knows about it. I mean, if he's read his email.
And that way, you could just include, you know, the PDF of last year's letter with it.
Yeah.
Or actually, the PDF.
Banner. Can you scan
both of these?
Well, where did that mean?
Say that again.
Banner
newspaper.
No.
Oh yeah. What's her name?
Yeah. What's
the editor? I forget her name.
Ken.
Ken
Cleveland.
Ken Cleveland. The girl's gone.
Girl's gone.
Yeah, she's left. Karen.
Well, why?
Goodness. All right. Well then, do we know the editor?
You don't like Ken?
What?
You don't like Ken?
Never met him.
He was the earlier reporter.
Oh.
Before this, Karen. He used to work here in the town.
But he's not. What's the name of the reporter before her?
Karen.
Karen was the girl.
Girl.
And then right before her was
Ken.
Michael
Caine.
Michael Caine.
Yeah.
No.
He's back?
Ken Cleveland.
Ken Cleveland.
Here's a signed copy. Can you scan and, I don't know, email?
Where's that? Go on the banner.
What?
Is it going to the banner?
Absolutely. Do you have a copy of the other letter?
Is
this person's name Ken?
Ken.
No, you will send it to Banner News.
This is whoever the editor of the banner is, whoever that is.
Yeah, Banner News.
If you're changing it like this, bang, bang, bang.
It should be on their website.
Right now it's Ken Cleveland.
Okay.
I would think there'd be an email address for Banner.
Just a general Banner.
Banner.
But otherwise, are we mailing it to this guy, or are you just going to hang on until is he going to be here? Is this just going to be here Monday?
Send it and I'll send it.
It's if it gets out in the mail though. You'll have
Just email. Just email. I'll hand Gary a copy.
Okay.
You should be able to get an email from him off MassDOT's website, I would think.
Okay.
Um,
And copy the board, and I'll just print out the signed copy.
Yes, that's a great idea.
I'd hand it to him.
That works.
Boom.
That works.
And see, cool. see how quickly you get
see
kicked
that?
Out.
Hey.
All right, so do we need to vote on that?
I don't think so.
No? Okay. It's all in all. We're all done with that one.
Board appears to support the letter.
Yes, right? Definitely. Yep.
Oh, you want to do it? Motion and then second, and then go?
Do we need a motion for the letter?
No.
Or just say?
I don't think so. It's just a letter.
Just a letter.
I think we're good.
All right.
We're all on the same page. How was your phone call?
Good. Gotta find some boxes.
What are your boxes for?
A friend's moving.
How many boxes do you want?
How many you got? Six, eight?
I have a house full of boxes. That's what we do. I can bring home, we have some 20.
He's got, textbooks he needs to.
So, I give small boxes so they don't get too heavy, you know? And then, I don't know, they're like 20 by 18 by 10 inches deep or something like that.
I was going to get some old paper boxes, the old printer.
They're about that size. I don't know.
That would be good.
If you have some of those, you can give them, I'll bring them 20. Well, does he need them soon?
Day after tomorrow?
If I can get them tomorrow, and I'll drop them off. I'll just put them inside the door here.
All right. We can talk after the meeting.
About free stuff.
All right,
next. Where's my minutes? Oh, you want to talk about your CMRPC?
Yeah. So I didn't know this. Eric Smith left CRPC.
Didn't he?
I actually
chased him out.
I saw Chris Ryan last week. I'll talk about this report. Some other boards. I went to a CMRPC meeting.
Yep.
He was there. I didn't get a chance to talk to him, but at any rate, Eric, I guess, has moved on to greener pastures. We wish him well.
Still alive, right?
Still
did
alive.
We say where he went? Is he?
He did not. Oh. He did not. I know he was. Wasn't he a town planner before CMRPC?
Yeah.
So I wonder if he moved on to another town planner position. I don't know. I'll have to do a Google search or something.
Yeah.
But anyways, so Chris mentioned in the email, I included his email, that because of that, they're a little bit behind, and what he's trying to do now is get in touch with all the towns that had done some work in this area, sort of figure out where things were left off, and then proceed. So I think things are still going,
rehash.
But yeah, there's a little.
Do you want to just
little hiccup?
Give an invite to whoever the replacement is to come to a meeting.
Absolutely.
You know, and then we'll just. I mean, I think that old guy emailed us that report that he did with some pictures and the map and everything.
Yes.
I mean, if
yes.
we can just. I'm sure they have it too, for that matter.
Yep.
We can just sort of go over that, and we'll sort of get the guy up to speed.
Absolutely.
We'll...
I'm supposed to be, I hope to have a quick call with Chris Ryan next week just to talk a little bit about this, let him know sort of where things were with us.
Yeah. I mean, if he can dig out the email too, or whatever files the guy had.
Yep. Because I recall the last time Eric was here, he presented some initial findings as far as, which lots that we had looked at were conforming, which ones were non-conforming, remember, as far as lot size and as far as use were concerned.
Actually, he had some statistics, too, which were interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I've got that slide deck. Yeah. So, I think it came out in an email. So we've got all that stuff.
Okay.
The question is now, I think, is still compiling that stuff and then having a discussion maybe with somebody from CMRPC as far as what do we want to do with that material.
And I thought we were leaning towards maybe just sort of fine-tuning our zoning to sort of what do we call it? Not the
village district.
No, what's there right now.
Oh, you mean
mixed use or something like that? We
were talking about trying to remove non-conformities, I think. Right?
Yeah, and sort of...
Write a bylaw so that the new zoning will include all the uses that currently exist, so it's not a non-conforming lot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
and
right.
And realign
right.
some of the zoning, because some of the... Like, the zoning would end, just like the lot before, like the old post office building.
Right. Halfway through
the building. So we could realign all that. And I thought if we realigned our zoning and called it, I think it's like a mixed use or something like that area right now. And I think we can get away with keeping it like that, maybe renaming that village district or something like that.
Right.
We wouldn't have to do too much. I mean, it seemed like, I thought our sort of semi-conclusion was that we sort of have these village districts going on right now. We just don't know it. Yeah.
Well, they're just not permitted that way. They're, or they're not zoned.
Or they're not quite zoned at all like that. I mean, the zoning stops before we really wanted to stop and things like that.
Yeah.
Now, another question that I have that that raises is, so if we're proposing, again, this would be a zoning bylaw amendment. What do you think are the chances of us getting through town meeting with something like, hey, we want to take this, you know, residential district and make it mixed use?
Well, that was part of the strategy too, was that make it a lesser degree would be to say, what we're trying to do here is realign our zoning to match up with what we really have. And it seems like we have all these businesses down the, from the library, we got the art studio, we got, you know, the market, we have the bathroom place or whatever it is now.
Yeah.
I don't know what, and this is in this area, but we don't call it anything. So what we want to do is realign our zoning to match what we have right now. And I think that you could get that through.
Yeah, I'm trying to be the devil's advocate here.
I think you have to ease that. I don't think you can say we're turning all these single residence areas into these village areas, you know, so that you can have a gas station and a lottery box and a.
Right.
You'll get a lot of questions.
And a shooting range.
And a shooting range.
Yes.
You need at least a half an acre.
We can.
Draw the line.
Work through it.
But I do think you should solve it. I don't think you have to, I don't think you could get through saying you're going to.
Yeah.
Change them.
Yeah, we'll have to think through how we're going to.
It might actually help the people behind Honey Farms if we were to, you know, change that to not be mixed use and make that just residential right there, because that's what that really is right now.
General residence, you mean?
Single residence. Oh, no, general residence, because I guess it's multiple.
But we want to figure out what we want, how to do it. It's going to take some more work, and then I think we're going to need to do some public meetings and do better outreach to the people. Because if we go in there thinking that we know what's right, even if we are 100% right, but the people that live there aren't aware of what we're trying to do,
and we have to be very careful when we publish.
So we need, right.
Yeah.
Because that seems to stir up a business there with Linda and.
There were some neighbors, recall, during the tour that.
Linda and, what's her, Brenda?
Well, but there's going to be them wherever we are in town, so we need to be.
But I think their whole thing was that they read the sort of stock.
The standard, which.
That we gave.
Yeah.
And they're like, what are you doing? You're going to put gas stations in people's backyards?
Right.
And,
they were right. You know? We didn't intend to do that, but they did the homework partially.
They read it, and then.
Right.
So we said, well, no, that's absolutely not what we're going to do. That's just a stop. I mean, I don't think that went over as well as.
So we need to be a little. We need to get our ducks in a row better.
Fair enough. Right. All right. So I'll follow up with Chris.
Just invite him.
And we'll take it from there.
Yeah.
That sounds good.
Measure my phone.
Other boards, the open space and rec plan, our public, our survey is still out there. Yep, we got 170 something, I think, responses. And so it's going well. We want people to respond.
Not honestly, just make it up.
We want you to respond the way you want to see the town in the future. It's the idea of what kind of recreational uses would be good. We're talking about some disc golf. Someone suggested, and I don't know that we're really going to have it, but I thought it was kind of new and interesting that they have these archery tournaments where they'll put little deer or whatever it might be out there, and just on one day at a time, and they have a daily tournament where they go out and play it like golf, and you shoot and try to get as close to the target, and then they go off to the next target, and they have this whole route.
Is it like golf where you go, and as you're retrieving your arrows, people are shooting in behind you?
Yeah, I think there's they don't just say four.
Yeah.
But it sounded like a neat idea. I'd never heard of it before. But, I mean, there's all sorts of new things out there. Disc golf, the.
A high ropes course?
No, that would be interesting, but they get rid of all the trees at the pine grove.
Makes it harder.
But there are a lot of different options. And what we want to do is hear people's ideas. Some people out there may have better ideas than what we've been thinking of because we've been doing it for a while in the open space. Parks has been really involved. The Parks Department and the Recreation Department, Jen Breen and Bob Dunn have been doing a lot of work kind of going through the old plan and updating it because we've had so many changes in the last 7-8 years since the last one was done. They're really going through and really paying attention to the way things should be, the process. Who's reporting to whom and how they all interact, so that we're going to try to improve the efficiency in the town.
So the process or the boards are getting moved, whatever they are.
Cooperation and, yep, cooperation and coordination is gonna be one of the items that is gonna be tried to be encouraged in this new plan and try to improve it. So we want people to fill out the survey and let us hear what you think.
That's great. You said 170 so far?
I think it was 174.
That's more than people that come, that's more than the number.
What happened today is, you know, that.
On meeting.
Yeah.
That link is archived. So I did post it on the Facebook too.
You did? Oh, good. Good. What does archive mean?
Because it's on the front page on the top, right? So if you go on the front page, if you come all the way a little halfway through, there is a link more. When you click the link more, it goes to a whole different page. On that page, you know, you have a number of links.
One of the links. So we're not on the front page anymore? Got bumped?
Check the camera.
Oh, I gotta slide her a little. All right, yeah.
It's all we know.
Don't feel bad, Andrew Jackson just got bumped from the front of the.
Oh, that's right, you're right. Right, well, it's, and it's only open through, I think, May 6th is what we have it running till, so there's only a few more days left.
I did post it on there.
Excellent, thank you.
This Boylston Connect.
Great.
Okay.
Sounds good.
I did have a meeting.
Oh.
Very briefly, CMRPC had a meeting at, I think it was in Grafton. No, it wasn't a breakfast. It was last Thursday, I want to say, in the evening. And the topic was solar bylaws and medical marijuana bylaws.
Nice.
Briefly, so solar, essentially the main topic was this idea of green communities. And if you sort of meet all the requirements to be quote unquote accepted by the state as a green community, then there's certain goodies that you can get along those lines.
I think we've sort of agreed that we don't, the town doesn't want to do that because we're an MLB.
Yes, it goes through this whole spiel for half an hour saying how great Green's community is, and then at the end, oh, by the way, if you have municipal power, you don't qualify.
Yeah. Yeah, like, okay. Right, frantically.
All right, two pages of notes down the drain, but hey. But it was interesting nonetheless.
Well, I think you can be a green community, except that the MLP has to charge the fee, and then you're not guaranteed to get it back.
Yeah, or they were saying if there was one house in town that was sort of off the municipal grid that was getting power from national grid or something like that, then you could qualify. Or I think they also said if you have utility gas, which we do.
No, you could slip it in that way.
That can be the basis for it as well, at least in theory. So that's another way of looking into it. But then you have to agree to all of these, you know, things. And I think one of the most contentious ones was the idea of the stretch building code that you have to sort of adopt in your community.
What is that?
Which is sort of, it's a quote unquote greener building code. So when you build
grass on the roof.
Yeah, your homes have to be built more energy efficient to higher standards than what the state building code requires.
Like required insulations more and junk like that.
Yeah, so. Those kinds of things.
Yeah, there's always a hook. That's one of the reasons I like the complete streets. There wasn't a requirement.
Yeah.
Most everything else you get from the state, I don't trust.
A long time ago, I was on the sustainability committee, and then Leon had asked us, do we want to do this?
Yeah.
And so we looked into it. There was me and Brenda and somebody else on the
board.
And we looked into it a little bit, and we went to the MLP, and they said, well, the only thing about it is everybody's electric bill goes up by whatever it is, $6 a month if you do this, and there's no, the MLP is very unlikely they're going to get a project, you know, that gets paid out by the Green Communities Act. So
I think it's one of these ideas that can be nice in theory, but for a variety of reasons.
Yeah, and I think it's just its favor towards National Grid being the collector and
So at any rate, we have municipal power, and we're getting a new solar panel.
Right, I don't think we're doing too badly.
I think we're.
And I think what he said, he was at the last meeting, he was saying how we're like the lowest rates
No increase in how many years?
No increase in, yeah, 7 years or something like that.
We're doing fine, so.
We're doing fine. And then just very briefly, the other topic, medical marijuana, no surprise here, we're sort of already ahead of the curve.
Oh, a lot of people don't have their marijuana license?
Yes, well, some towns have, you know, their own versions, some don't have any, and some have, you know, something similar, I presume, to what we have. Actually, the concerns that were raised, actually, this is, I'm sorry, this is one last thing going back to the solar panels. There were some concerns that were raised from towns as far as they actually wanted to see whether it was possible to have a bylaw to limit how many solar panels can be in town, because in some towns, they're cropping up all over the place.
You mean on residences?
Yeah, even in residential areas. And so they were talking a little bit about, well, can we do something to sort of regulate that? We don't want the whole town to be one big solar panel, essentially.
Why not? Why wouldn't
some people think it looks ugly?
Some people.
Well, and they don't like the turbines, the wind turbines. Oh, geez, these people.
Yeah. So that was an interesting discussion. Medical marijuana, I think the only thing of interest there is, as far as recreational marijuana now, evidently it's going to be on the ballot coming up in, what is it, September, November, whenever the state election is.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for recreational. This is sort of a yes or a no question to legalize. And so if that happens, then there's a question as far as how is the medical aspect and the recreational aspect, how are they going to sort of work together, because there are different issues when it comes to security, when it comes to access, when it comes to...
Well, maybe you don't. You say the higher one wins, and that's what everybody has to do.
Yeah, and so, I mean, it's an unknown at this point how that's all going to work out, but it's just sort of a heads up, as we'll see what happens with the state.
Did anybody talking about that, did anybody ask about, like, what is going on in Colorado? Because now they have, you know, medicinal and recreational. I'm just curious. I mean, you don't hear nothing in the
news. I think you hear all sorts of things about
if it's been good, bad, or indifferent. So I'm just thinking, you know, when you went to this and they were talking about that, you know, about on the ballot, has anybody checked out Colorado to see how it's going?
I think Colorado's, the news I keep hearing from Colorado is that they're making tax money on this hand over fist, and they don't know what to do with it all.
Yeah, but the problem is that the people that are involved in this, they can't put their money in a bank because the federal government can seize it.
Yep.
So that's why they have these humongous vaults.
Yeah, it's illegal federally.
Right, federally.
Oh, yeah. That's an interesting problem.
That's a Schedule I substance control.
Even though they're paying the tax.
Colorado.
Yeah. Well, anywhere that has medicinal, it's illegal. They cannot put their money into a bank. In other words, if you have, like, if somebody came into town
because it's what?
The
banks are federally insured.
They can't put the money into the
bank. And they seize the money?
Because it's illegal.
Okay.
Really? Well, they're worried of the risk the banks are, I guess. So banks are sort of hands off. They won't
talk about laundering.
So that's an issue for another day, I guess. But it was a good meeting.
That's good.
That's that.
Thank you for going.
Not a problem. I actually made this one. Let's see if I can
go. It was an hour too long, so we get an extra couple hours of
maybe an hour and a half
community service. Good.
Yeah, it fills our bank.
It's our bank
service.
Is
there a quarterly meeting coming up?
There were a couple of meetings coming up. Let me see.
Yes.
A couple of meetings. So there's. Let's see. General information workshop on municipal electricity aggregation. That didn't
look good. What's that, Mr. Fitch?
Then there was a planner's forum, but that was in the middle of the day. I'm not going to be able to go to that. And they were going to talk about form-based codes as opposed to sort of what we have.
Was it?
The more sort of, they call it a form-based code. I'm not sure exactly what that is, but
that's an interesting model.
I don't think we have that here. One that did catch my eye, that I'm going to try to get to is Economic Development Commission gathering with CMRPC. I don't know if our economic development folks.
Who's our economic development person?
Nobody is there.
John Hadley.
Oh, Rogers.
Yeah, I'm there.
No.
Were you aware of that one, the economic development thing?
No.
So it's May 18th at 6:30, so it would be the Wednesday after our next meeting.
Okay, 18, yeah.
And then there's a CMRPC breakfast, legislative affairs with the Lieutenant Governor, Karen Polito. That's Friday, May 20th, but that's in the morning.
It's breakfast.
Difficult to go to, yeah, breakfast. And then the annual meeting and dinner is June 9th, Thursday.
At Union Station with dancing down.
It's actually Leicester Country Club this year. They're doing some golfing.
So you need a babysitter there?
Bring him.
Thursday, June 9th. What am I doing that day? I'll have to look it up.
It's a daytime meeting?
5:30, so could go after work.
Sounds early enough.
Yeah, so have to check that out. Busy schedule.
I must have had a meeting of the Affordable Housing Trust. I don't remember what to know.
What's the status on finding land areas? I haven't gotten anything back. I got an introduction from Pat Halpin to whoever the woman is, and then I've not heard anything.
We're sort of trying to keep her from just billing. So we're trying to.
Well, let's get her to do something. I mean,
yeah, we just let her bill.
Well, I guess what I'm looking for is so that there's, if something comes before the ZBA, we at least have a document that says, these are the facts that we're basing our decision that we meet the 1.5% standard, so we don't have to approve a 40B project.
I think we should just say.
Well, I think we're going to say it anyway, but I want to be able to have the facts there.
So you're just going to have her confirm?
Because, I mean, the facts that I have are from 2011. Karen Paray pulled a lot together, so let's just update it.
What's changed?
That is the question.
Oh, no, there's two, there's the ones you gave us, the...
Angel Brook. We've gained Angel Brook.
Yeah.
So we should be even better on it.
Yeah, okay.
But I want to confirm.
I'm going to send that to Pat just so that...
Because we haven't lost the North Main Street. They were active, I heard.
We're working on that today.
Yeah.
And last night.
Looking up to the sewer, I think.
Well, they did the water connection last night, worked most of the night.
Oh, yeah.
And had a couple of people upset. Yes, that's the one that I saw, but we need land area associated with each one of those. That's the SHI, but it doesn't have land area of each of the units. Remember how we calculated that if you have 1.5% of your available land in...
Well, the percent that subsidizes is 4.98.
Yep, so we're not close to the 10% required, so we want to have that alternative standard, which we meet.
And then there's also the denominator of that. It's 10%. It's 4% something, and you're gonna calculate your total area.
Right, and that's what I had sent. That's what initiated that whole thing. Because in the last couple of years, DCR has bought 100 acres or so, and that comes off the denominator, so the percentage goes up
because of that.
Okay. 100 out of like 4,000, but it's still
it's in the right direction.
Yeah.
Okay.
I thought she was going to provide all that information to you guys.
She was. I think she did an SHI, but I don't think she did the land area part.
I thought that was going to be all, but when Dick Heaton did it, it had everything.
Yeah, I think that's what she has to do again.
You know, and then of course, and then this one's kind of weird because this one says when they're talking about Oakdale, right? It shows that. It says total SHI units, and it shows that Oakdale is rental, but it shows zero for total SHI units. Shouldn't it have
all
20 of
them? No, because, well,
all
and
units,
then,
87 or something, whatever.
Well, 80 units total, and they're all rentals.
Yeah.
Right. You would get credit for all of them, but I'm pretty sure.
You get credit for all the land, I think.
Yes, but the SHI, you still get credit for the land because the permit is in place, but if there's no building permit, there's like a time period. We got
that's what he was talking
the
about.
Building permit was good for a year. I think that expired at the time they submitted that. So everything's still on the books, but because the permits went a long time, they haven't really started the work.
they come off the SHI, but they will go back on the SHI, which is what you're looking at, subsidized housing inventory.
So the total SHI units is how many are?
How many get credit for?
How many get, okay, because see, on Alpha Terrace, they only have down here is 9.
That's because those are ownership.
It should be 15.
Oh,
should be 13.
13, sorry.
So where's the other 4?
That's the other question. We've had that question, that's what someone is going to be looking into.
You guys want some good news? Somebody bought the motel.
Really?
Yep, $240,000.
Affordable housing?
I don't know, somebody bought it, $240,000 to pay for it.
Hmm, really?
Yeah, they got these, all these blue and yellow and red little flags out there, I guess they've been out there surveying and stuff.
Place is vacant now?
It's been vacant.
Yeah, that's good.
So I don't know what they're going to do with it.
Good. Hey, did everybody read the Tajin thing?
I did?
Yeah.
On the preliminary, yes.
Yeah. Did you read the Tajin thing on the preliminary thing? I did not.
It wasn't really focused on the facts of the subdivision. It was...
No, it's this thing about the land.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which... I think it's water under the bridge. It's already gone. And
well, we can't have this guy do anything about it. The guy who's doing the preliminary plan.
No.
Yeah, that would come up when he does the real deal, right? We can
definitive, but I don't think it's not going to have anything to do with that.
No.
It was so we should let Tajin talk for it. We should have a meeting with just Tajin. You know, have him just sit here talking for 2 hours. And then we'll have the real meeting. Just because I don't know. So, any other meetings? Did Raj, where'd he go?
He was just in a SWAT meeting, or?
Is he?
Well, I thought he was.
Like right now?
No.
He's keeping us in suspense.
Wait, is he meeting us?
Well, he's gone. Do you want to do meeting minutes?
Yes.
Did you add to the minutes the notes?
You told me I did.
Okay, good. All right, then I approve them 100%.
You didn't read it.
I read the first time. Good God. What are you asking me to do?
Which one? The public hearing?
The solar panel, I had that first paragraph of the issue to green card button notification.
Okay.
Need to be submitted.
Notice of decision to grant variances? I guess I'm stuck in my zoning board of appeals stuff.
SWAT? Did you have a SWAT meeting?
I
just a few minutes back.
I'm going to go in. Where is everyone?
Yeah, we had a couple of meetings too. Mine.
One
One is the ZBA and one is the SWAT meeting.
All right.
Do SWAT first.
No, SWAT, you know, we talked about, you know.
I want to be able to recycle my pellet bags.
Your what?
Pellet bags. Like the pellets I pour into my stove to heat the house, they come in plastic bags.
Yeah, that's one of the things that we talked about, the plastic bags. Where do we recycle? So is there any company takes the recycling?
You can't just take them to the grocery store?
No.
You can take the grocery bags, you can't take the pellet bags.
Pellet bags, as long as they were number 4, it's the same process.
No, that's a big bag, right? Pellet
it's
bags.
Heavy. It's much heavier.
Yeah, thank you.
I don't even know if it's
not like the grocery bags.
I don't have pellets.
You should get pellets.
I get logs, that's enough.
What do you do with the bags they come in?
You want to continue your report?
Yeah, and then we talked about what are we going to do, what are we going to talk in the town meeting?
Oh, for the SWAT.
Yeah, how much money for the bag fees, how much ton?
Are the fees going up? Is there any change to it? So it's all staying the same?
At this time, no.
Good. How's our recycling rate?
So this, I think it ought to.
Staying the same, going up, going down?
Same. No, at this time staying the same. But they are going to, now we are the, is it single stream or double stream?
Oh, no.
That's what's going to happen. When it happens, yeah.
We're going to go back to dual stream so I can put out my cans on one time and my paper on the next week?
So if you don't do it, the price will go up. That's what they're saying.
Don't do it. It's free.
Yeah. It's,
so it's going to double?
Yep.
Okay, good.
So which we don't know yet.
I missed something. You said it's free and you're gonna double the price, so I don't mind you doing that.
Okay. The rate for the trash is $65 per ton.
Okay.
The cost for single stream recycling is $45 per ton. Both the cost is included in our current contract. However, that will change when we renew 4 years.
So in 4 years, we have to renew a contract and the prices are gonna be higher.
Yeah.
So we're trying to mitigate that increase.
Yep.
And to do that, it might be just to go to dual stream?
Dual stream might be cheaper than what we're doing now.
You're gonna keep the rate the same? Okay. But we have 4 years to figure it out?
When our contract expires in 4 years.
Is it in 4 years or will be a 4 year contract?
In 4 years. Expires in 4 years.
So recycle all your stuff now and then throw it away in 4 years.
They recommend switching to dual stream recycling, which has no charge.
Oh.
They means
no charge.
Yeah.
So the fees will go down. You said it's 45,000 to recycle?
45 per ton.
But it'll be zero per ton if we do dual stream?
That's what it says. But I don't know.
So will the prices of the bags?
Will they get bigger?
I wonder how that will be impacted.
They probably won't do anything.
Those things are not.
They didn't talk. Well, that's good. So at least they're trying to keep the costs low. So that's the idea. That's good.
So this, they were talked with one of the representatives from Michael, Republic Division Managers.
Mm-hmm.
The last meeting.
Oh, okay.
This meeting, you know, they briefed us.
That's okay.
I was not present at that time.
Sounds good.
And then the big meeting?
The ZBA meeting was very good. So finally, you know, the outcome is...
So you were just made a decision and you decided...
This is it.
This is on Wayne's.
Yeah. Uphold the building inspector's decisions.
So the appellate.
It's 4-1 vote. One of the CBA member, David Finia, didn't vote for it. Against.
I read it in the banner today.
Yeah.
Oh,
hot off the press.
I hear it was on YouTube, right? Or it was.
Yeah.
All those videos is there.
All 4 hours of it?
Yeah.
Was that?
Without
With
any,
the expletives or without the expletives?
No, without edits. No edits.
No edits?
No edits.
No edits.
So it's like a
you can watch
you have to log in with your.
Do you that, say you're 18?
Yeah. But
that's what, you know, the girls that do this were complaining about. I gotta edit this for 16 hours to try to get this out.
But they said, you know, some of the places the voice is not clear, the audio is not clear.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they are recording here. Some of them had the mic, some didn't have a mic. That's the reason. So that's about it.
All right. So that was decisions made.
Decisions made.
I heard some noise yesterday, I think it was, but. It's been pretty quiet, so it's been all right now.
We'll see.
Tomorrow?
Well, the concerned citizens of West Boylston haven't decided on if they're going to take any further action or not.
Well, don't, I mean, you have to file your decision, and then they have 20 days, is it?
They are waiting for the decision.
Has your decision been submitted?
Not yet, it's... I think, you know.
Who's doing that? Is that the board or town council, hopefully?
I don't know.
Okay.
I left it for the chair.
That's all right. It's not ours.
Way,
good luck with you guys.
After the meeting, it's not very nice.
So there was some outburst, you know. So.
4 hours is almost as long as a planning board meeting.
That's, No, it's not as bad.
Yeah, but you didn't have 300 people.
There were that many people there?
Well, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
They all had t-shirts on that said, what did it say? I'm for Wayne or something?
I stand with Wayne?
I stand with Wayne.
What's that t-shirt?
It says I stand with Wayne.
All right.
Wait, no, I have something to add to that. Hold on.
Oh.
I thought that, I guess I'll just weigh in. Who's the guy who's quitting? John?
Yeah.
Benson.
John had this, he started to go down this route, which I thought was very clever. It was like a law issue to keep them under control, which I thought was clever.
Accessory use and primary use?
Yeah. And what he was trying to do, I think, was say, at some level, when you're, you could set some boundary that makes it the primary use, which then makes it non-conforming with zoning.
Yeah.
And I thought that was a clever way to sort of keep it under control, and you could sort of do, I don't know exactly how you'd set that, a noise or number of complaints,
yeah, but,
or, you know, something like that.
But who will put the restrictions?
Well, I don't know how you'd put it in place, except that you'd have to have a...
No, which is too much. That's what is question.
It's what?
What is too much?
Well, that's what you have to
where
establish.
You are passing
that would be the
boundaries.
Zoning that would have to go through, is establishing where you go and your... Where the use becomes the primary use on the property,
yeah,
and how you set that sort of boundary level or something like that.
Yeah.
And that would have to be a zoning rule or something like that.
No.
I mean, I think it would have to be a zoning rule, because I don't think you could have it just a...
So you'd have to have a town meeting and a zoning, mm-hmm, a new zoning bylaw for noise. Is that what you're saying?
No,
that's one of the things. I don't know where it would fit in.
I think, you know, what he was
establish that.
I think what he was saying is, you know, it's not the board has to say 2% is too much, 10% is 10% in this kind of place is too much. It's not that board. It has to be done by the bylaw, and it has to go.
That's one of the reasons
people.
It should be bylaw.
The town people has to decide how many in a private gun range, how many people is too many people at a time.
Right.
Those are all regulations. It's not there in our bylaw, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think...
Oh, right, no.
This is a very unique case.
It's a unique case. I think, I do think the ZBA would be within its rights to sort of take a look at the schedule of use that's in the zoning bylaws and try to interpret where, you know, the residential use and whatever else, yeah, or however else you want to characterize.
Well, if it's a resident, that has to be the primary use.
Exactly.
You know?
But, you know, they might be able to interpret what the zoning bylaws and the schedule of use there to mean, okay, well, if it's a primary residential use, that means you can, you know, do X, Y, and Z, but you wouldn't be allowed to do something else. Now, he's right. I think how you define that is
right,
probably pretty difficult.
Yeah. Right.
But I think it's within the ZBA's power.
I just thought it was a clever way to...
Because you're interpreting
that
bylaws.
That would be the only way to take this problem and make it controllable. You know?
Yeah.
I mean, that's... I don't know if you're going to do it any other...
Well, the other thing that was
unless just impose something on.
Yeah.
The other thing that was mentioned was something about zoning bylaw back in 1946.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly what? And that was my contention. I wanted to see that, but they...
The zoning bylaw from 46?
Yeah.
It was kind of what was the place when they bought the place.
It had something to do with how this land became what it did. I would imagine. Or what was the zoning? What was the zoning bylaw,
you know,
back in 1946?
No, it's just basically says what is a single family residence. It's there in the bylaw. It's there in the town office.
But the other half of that would be trying them or somebody trying to establish. Okay, so you have the zoning bylaw. Now let's establish what the situation was.
But the burden would have been on Mr. Armstrong to prove that was.
Yeah, or show it somehow. I mean. Who,
yeah, but also, you know, he was all along
very familiar about all
this. Yes.
But he was all along saying, you know, we were using that property for recreational.
Yeah.
I think that they could say it's been continuously being done like this
that's
for a long time.
That's
a little bit. But I don't know if they could prove it at all.
Yeah.
You know?
Right. Well, and there's that whole thing. But then, when it becomes a couple people in the backyard shooting compared to. Anyone can go on my property anytime.
Yeah. Do whatever you want to do.
That's where,
you know,
somehow it's difficult to draw a line.
Yeah.
No, he also says, you know, that time I had only 2 friends. Now I have 70 friends.
So
my friend circle increased.
Well, the thing that I look at it is that if it were my backyard and I took a couple of friends out, or if I took 50 friends out, I'd be out there with them. And if we got too loud, the police would come out, whether I was shooting or having a party in the backyard. And if it becomes a nuisance or a bother to the neighbor, disturbing the peace, whatever the phrase might be, the standard should still apply.
In your opinion, you know, what is too many? How many people is too many?
If we have 100 people out there and everybody's meditating in the backyard, it's not too many. Yeah. If you got 100 people out there screaming at the top of their lungs.
So how do we put the language, you know? Then it's the problem.
Is it?
Well, I'm not saying that it's easy, but I think that's the mechanism.
Yeah. But I don't think it's a number of people that is the trigger.
Yeah, but again, you know, we need to put the language, but there is no language there.
Right, no, and it's the ZBA isn't the one to make the language.
ZBA is not going to make the law, right?
Right.
Yeah, and the other thing that's tricky here too is, I don't know if this came up, but the other thing that I think makes it trickier is there's a state law involved here that seems to sort of carve out
animals and things like that.
Protection for nuisance.
No.
Well, for nuisance, there's one. There's also a state law that I thought where you were going was that allows existing rightfully properly permitted and operated gun ranges to be exempt from the noise thing.
Yeah.
But he is not a licensed and approved gun range, so that doesn't even apply. That's where I thought you were going.
And I don't even think there's much to...
Well, I think that's one of the findings I think that the ZBA will have, which is going to at least define some of this structure here, so that when they make their decision, there's going to be findings in there, like we do.
Yeah.
There are going to be findings, this is what occurred, this is... Mr. Armstrong has been doing this since 1980 or whatever the date he's been doing it from. It's gotten a little bit larger, or it's gotten larger, whatever it is. So the findings are there, and those are pretty much undisputed.
Right.
And hopefully that's going to be part of the decision. And then that's when the abutters will decide whether they want to appeal it because either their findings are wrong or they disbelieve that, or they can appeal it for a whole bunch of different reasons. And that's what they're going to look at is the decision to appeal. And it's an appeal. It's not as though they're suing the Zoning Board of Appeals. It's an appeal of their decision, but it has to go to court.
And all this discussion is just discussion. It's not. We don't really think
we have no authority.
We have no authority to do anything. We're just discussing what the meaning.
Reports from other boards.
Yeah, just reports from other boards, I guess. Right. Now, do we want to meeting minutes? Which I guess that's where they came from.
Is that right? It's only 10 of 8.
Oh.
Well, we started at 6.
We can actually read these.
Still, we got to meet on Friday more often. It's pretty good.
All right.
We even had a public hearing.
Yeah, we did pretty good.
Mm-hmm. All right. Just had. So this is the motion to approve the minutes from April 13th, the meeting and the public hearing.
Second.
All of them? Going to do all of them at once?
Yeah, unless people have, for the zoning bylaws, the solar panel array, and then the regular meeting minutes.
Second.
Wait, I have a little bit of discussion. I just want to see what we said about the... the addition to talk about ZBA Wayne's weapons, are you, Mr. Okay, good. All right, yeah. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Nice.
Is that mine? No, it's just the ZBA minutes.
No, not that.
Who's supposed to read?
That's it.
It's a ZBA variance.
No, it's Graves. Graves Engineering meeting minutes. Anybody want to read?
Oh, when they did the site visit at Cumberland Farms? Looks like they're moving forward.
They are.
And what was... Cumberland Farms, they're the southern lot. In our approval for the Cumberland Farms, we specifically said that southern property on the 184 or 187, it doesn't have site plan review anymore.
Yeah.
Because the old site plan review was replaced by this one.
Yeah.
And when we talked to Cumberland Farms, they didn't include that area in their site plan review, which is what we... permitted.
Is there some contention here?
Well, I'm not sure. I saw a sign there for a free zone or something like that. I'm not sure if there's something happening. So if you could contact the building inspector and confirm that he's has an issue on the southern end, or if he has, why is he aware that the old site plan review expired?
Okay. What's his name? Bentley.
Bentley.
Yes.
You don't have to, I was going to recycle it. Southern Europe.
MA, oh, Mike, Andrew.
All right, that's on VHB, 99 Hartwell, another $3,600?
Those are the ones I didn't pay, when they finally did pay.
Do we get more money from them?
Yeah, they're good.
Okay.
$7,500 or whatever, right?
Oh, they did? Oh, good.
Still waiting on Ali for that other invoice, so you might want to contact him again.
How much?
Whatever it is, I've sent you like three or four times.
We need to bump that up a little, because I got a complaint from...
Oh, that's true, we should talk about that one, too.
The people across the street from the new circle, that the drainage...
The Prospect?
Prospect Street, yes. There were problems with the drainage coming down the constructed newer circle, going across the road and into their property.
But it's not directly across the street, because I know those people...
Yeah, it's a little further, right.
Yeah, okay.
So...
It's probably more of all these properties, then.
I don't know the details, but VHB was out there, and he recommended that they do some work and open up, I guess, the catch basins to collect the rainfall were covered over and plated and covered with dirt, so that the water wasn't going into the system. So it was just coming right down and going out. So he said, okay, let's go straighten this out, and so hopefully things have been addressed there. I don't know, I haven't heard anything from that neighbor, but it was an email that was kind of surprising, it shouldn't have been that way, but VHB said they hadn't been out there in a long time. And what I directed VHB to do, and I want to just get confirmation from you folks, was to go out there at least monthly and stay on top of it, whether they call or not. It's their responsibility to call VHB and say nothing's changed, or they're going to go out there and get billed for it. Because so far, we've had two times where they never called VHB and stuff kind of went south, when they were doing the backfill of the trenches with the materials.
Oh, change for everybody, not just for Ali.
Right, right.
Okay.
Well, for that project, because that project was backfilling the trenches.
I thought you were talking about the back, the trenches over at 99.
No, that was something, yeah, that's VHB is not reviewing for us, they're out there reviewing for the ZBA. They're their review engineer for the 99 Hartwell Street, I think.
Is that right?
I'm sorry, not 99, I'm sorry, I was thinking 94 North Main Street.
No, for the 99 Hartwell Street.
Same thing with 99 Hartwell, we're being consistent.
They did something, they didn't do something.
Right, we want consistent monitoring, supervision.
Or monitoring, period, yeah.
So that's, I'm just hoping you guys agree that that's the way to go, but...
Should we start with a case by case? Like, we'll start, let's try the next few before we make a policy?
Oh, I don't know, just the general idea is that we want to make sure they're doing what they need to do.
We got three that we want to sign.
Is he doing any work up there?
Just building the houses.
That's it?
Yep. He hasn't requested any releases or put a bond out, I don't think, so...
So he's not selling the houses?
Right, so now he's just building them, in a couple of weeks probably, or a month, he's going to want a release on the lots. Because right now he has a covenant, so we need to make sure that covenant and the homeowners association is in its place and all that stuff is ready before we do a bond.
Yeah, I don't think, you know, going out there once a month is...
Well, I mean...
A bad idea.
Except all winter or something, when we know that...
Yeah, well, that's, and they did, but they never said when they started.
Yeah, and they're going to start working.
Right, they'll start working again, it sounds like a good time.
Especially when he, I think the response to that was, Ali, what are you doing? Oh, yeah, we've been screening alone for 16 days or something like that, trying to get all the grades, you know, to work out. You're like, oh, if you didn't get around to telling us that you're doing any of this.
2 weeks, and that's the thing, is that, yeah, it's not a high priority for them, so...
Right.
We'll just have them get charged, I mean, that's the only way that...
That he's going to pay attention.
Yeah.
I mean, can we send that to Ali in an email?
Yeah.
So he's aware upfront, this is what's going to go on. Oh, and by the way, you're still required to inform VHB when you are doing, you know, a certain...
Between the monthly visits.
Right.
Right.
Just to remind him of that.
But, yeah, I mean, I guess you'd hope that he'd be clever and call, don't come on the 16th like you always do, please come on the 11th, because that's when we're doing something.
That's why I think if there's a standing order, then he'll be more motivated to do that, I would think, right?
Yep.
Yeah, because they're going to show up late, and they're going to miss something. Yeah.
And then they're going to have to come back, and he's going to get charged for it.
And he's going to have to come back, right? Yeah.
You know?
Right. I mean, we've had some contractors who were like right there. Okay, we need you. We're doing this in 2 days. Can you schedule it in? Yep. And they get out there, they look at it, and everything goes smoothly. It's kind of working similar to that on Holy Cross. They're doing a good job up there. They don't call a lot, but when there's something that's coming up, they're starting to do that now. But I think that's what happened. They got burned once. VHB went out there and charged them for an inspection when they didn't really need it. So but they never let anyone know, so now they're making sure they're not wasting any money at all.
Good.
That's right.
Good.
Anything else? I don't think we have anything else. Do you have anything else?
No.
Anything? Want a motion to close?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Oh, wow, a 2-hour meeting.
That means 2:00.